Hey guys, this is Gilbert, and today I'll be playing Villa Nueva in the 515 pool. And it looks like we have a French defense. I like to play the advanced French, get a nice space advantage. I play c3 here. If he captures, I can capture back. Normally, we get the knights out, and we have some pressure with the queen. This is one of my favorite openings to play as white. I like playing against the French. It's fun. Gets sharp. Queen b6 is normal. Let's capture. So maybe the idea is knight to f5. Maybe I'll play a3, b4. Let's do that. If the knight hits, we have enough defenders, a queen and the knight. So we're good on that front. Notice we're defending against a check. We can play b4. The bishop may one day go to b2, support this d4 square. Really, in the French, it's just a battle for the d4 square. Okay, that's odd. I thought the knight was better suited on this square. Let's get some space. I don't think I need to castle right away. He hasn't castled either. Let's get the. I don't think the bishop is good on d3. Can be kicked by the knight. I don't want that. This knight coming in. Should I be worried about that? Actually, he can't come in. Would be dropped. So again, let's reconsider bishop to d3. Let's play it. I don't really see how more pressure is going to be ramped up against d4, so I can afford to take away the queen's protection. Plus, I'm going to be playing bishop to b2 pretty soon. Let's castle. Bishop b2 is on the agenda. Getting a rook on c1 is going to happen. Possibly knight to d2. We're doing good so far. Notice that the knight could jump into f4 once my bishop goes to b2. Where's my bishop ending up in that case? Do I want to just chop the knight away? I don't think so. What about bishop to e3? Protecting d4 that way. Maybe that would be more convenient. Let's do that. I don't want to leave this diagonal, give the bishop a good square. I don't want to let the knight jump into f4. I do want to protect the pawn, and I do want to get a rook on c1. So I think it's a good option for now, at least. probably castles is gonna be played. I can start thinking about knight to d2. Also possible is knight to c3 and then into a4. Getting rid of the size of the square. Knight to c3, rook over. I can't play. I guess I could. Knight over. Bishop captures, queen captures, rook down. No, it's a check. Okay, let's go for it. I thought the rook would get active on c3, but I guess not. There's not enough time for my opponent to do that. There's a check. What to do against a move like b5? Maybe knight to e2 in that case, or rook to c1. Possibly even a4. Okay, if a4, we're draining this pawn. Pawn captures, knight captures, even. Yeah, let's do that. Not yet. We don't want to drop our pawn. Rook to c1 makes some sense. Maybe just knight to e2, clearing up the e file. Queen e2, maybe. Let's put the queen on this square. That way our rooks are connected. We can start playing moves like rook to c1. I didn't want my queen to have to capture this rook if exchanges were made of the rooks on the c file. Probably next is just going to be rook to c1. We're probably going to see castles. Notice he did invest some time moving the knight back. I don't really know what that was about. Maybe he was fearful of b5. Let's see, rook to c1, maybe h4. H4 doesn't work, two pieces away. What about g3, h4? Let's play g3. Take away some squares from the knight. Getting ready to play h4. Look at these bishops lined up against the king, these nice diagonals. this knight coming into play this way. I see my pieces activating pretty quickly towards the king side. Let's get ready for that. I want to play h4. So we're just getting ready to play h4. This knight might get kicked away. Might have to go to h8 possibly. If not, the rook would have to scoot over to give the square a knight on f8. We could start trying to break with pawn to h6, create some weaknesses that way. Then our pieces can slowly start moving in. It looks like my opponent will get into some time pressure pretty soon, although we do have a big increment. Notice that this knight is out of play, this bishop is out of play. That can be an issue with the French defense. If you're not careful, those two pieces can get pretty bad. Especially in the advanced variation, if you're not careful, you can get stormed on the king side. Let's see, should I just capture? Let's get the knight over. Let's pre-move that. Notice our queen is defending the square. We're moving this guy closer to the king's side, and we're protecting against a threat on the queen's side. Notice we're also covering a possible infiltration square of c3. The rook could have before more easily got there, but now we have a knight here. So it's going to be harder to do so. Against knight to c6. Probably just trade rooks, queen captures. Okay, no, none of that. Let's go ahead with our plan. What to do here? Trading rooks, maybe. What if I just ignore it? Bishop captures. to do rook fb1 doesn't work, rook captures, and then our defender's gone. I feel like I can just ignore this. Let's move on with our plan. If knight captures, okay, not a capture. Let's try to open up. If bishop captures, I might just scoot over here. Queen to c2, threatening a check. Let's grab that. We're hitting the rook. If he captures with the king, I can grab the rook. Let's grab this knight. He's defending. We want to take away as many defenders as we can. Knight over. Let's protect this guy. Let's pre-move that. We might get bishop captures. We do not. Let's get our knight in. Let's pre-move this capture again. I'm trying to get my knights involved. To do. Let's try for this. Trying to possibly sack. We do get a fork. Let's just sidestep that again. To do. Let's grab. We're attacking the bishop. Where's the bishop going? To do 40 seconds. Queen ogre captures, then what? We're attacking the square. I don't think that was the best move, but had to play something. I don't want to flag. My queen needs to get in somehow. Let's get ready. I think that drops. Notice I have enough pieces to where I can promote. Well, there we go. Made a one. Very sloppy ending by my part. Good game. So we had a lot of pressure, we just weren't able to get our knights really active here. Yeah, I wasn't too sure about. Let's go through the start of the game. So, French defense. Here, I'm not sure if a3 is the best move, but I thought it was a good step forward. It's not definitely, it's not bad by any means. I like b4, just taking away squares from the bishop and from the knight. Yeah, just prompting, pushing already is a good thing to do. I guess I was more concerned about king safety. Again, pushing h4, gaining space, trying to kick the knight. I should have noticed that a knight on g6 can be kicked pretty easily by the h-pawn. Yeah, so we see the plan of g3, h4. It's pretty clear. And now we go for it. Okay, so it looks like I dropped a pawn. H4 seems good, but what about this capture? Does it matter? No, I guess not. Breaking open the structure, it's just hard for my opponent here. We get too many weaknesses. Look at these dark squares, they're so weak. But instead, I decided to bring my knight over. Again, I should have just gone with my plan of h4, h5. That's why I played g3 in the first place. Here, I wasn't really sure what rook here would do. After knight here. Or even a move like. Maybe bishop here? h4, knight here. Yeah, I guess it helps me double on the a file. So I missed that opportunity. I thought once it got kicked by the knight, it would be bad. But it is covered. The bishop's defense of the pawn is covered by the knight. So we're doing great here. We didn't have to chop the knight. This guy was a good attacking piece, and I got rid of him. Here is odd. Is the dark squared bishop that important to get rid of? I know the dark squares are weak. Yeah, look at this square. It can be defended, can it? Sidestepping checks. It's interesting. Notice the tension around the dark squares and the position. All because of this g-pawn. He's gone. The cover of the king is lost. But we're still winning in this position. Now, I didn't like knight f4 after I played it. The intention was to do something with my knight, but what to do? I see that probably a push was encouraged by the engine. Let's say a nothing move is played. Oh, knight here. Okay. Just trying to get into this square. Let's say we go in for it right away. Yeah, so now our queen is more active. We can get more active in the game. What happens if this is captured? Ah, mate in threes. Yeah, this is pretty killer. Yeah, so this is pretty bad. Knight to h4 didn't address any issues that I had in the position. Here, I wasn't sure what to do. I see that he can't capture because of promotion, right? But, oh, okay, so we're draining in this square. Eventually. Engine says about equal. So cash out is what the engine says. I can't believe white isn't winning. It's a small advantage here. Again, we did sack the knight. Not much to do. Too many pieces involved now. But we got this tactic. And notice that this bishop is doing a great job of supporting this promotion. And that's how we won the game. That's all I have for you guys. If you guys like this video, please hit that like button. Please leave any comments, suggestions below. Thanks for watching. Bye.